Praise the Lord, everyone. This is Apostle Edward Chance, Prophet Leonard Chance, from Sword Eagle Ministries in Scottsdale, Arizona, Echo Ridge. We'd like you to invite all your friends, our friends, on Facebook and Periscope. You can see us later on YouTube. We want to welcome all of those in California, North Carolina, Connecticut, wherever you may be this morning, Alabama. God has got a word for us today, but let's listen for a moment to Jesus culture. We do not own the rights to the music, and so let's listen to it and enjoy it for a moment as you invite your friends to come in and be with us today. Let's worship the Lord today.
As I breathe in every word that you spoke, my heart is wide open. My heart is wide open. As I breathe in every word that you spoke.
So prophetic. Yes. Is his word alive for you today?
Amen.
The words that he's spoken to you, is your heart open to what God is speaking? Amen. Or are we still trying to walk in our own preconceived ideas? It's a good thing to think about, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to welcome again all of you at Soar Neighbor Ministries. Thank God for you today. We want to again continue to thank you for your prayers and support to this ministry, to the work of God here.
Amen.
As we move forward, and I want to say that I truly enjoyed Pastor Edwards' message last Sunday morning. It was just, he has just such a unique way of bringing God's word, and I like that because he's bringing the way God gives it to him, and it brings life
yes.
and encouragement to the people. And so we're looking forward to him next week being back here, and eventually pretty soon, hopefully Pastor Britt will be ministering for us as well. And also I wanted to, probably sometime we don't talk a whole lot about, but I want to thank the Lord for Sister Melissa, Prophet Melissa, as God continues to train her, and she's a speaker here at Soar Neighbor Ministry, but she
yes.
Wears so many hats that we are such, she's so invaluable to us and to the ministry and to you this morning. And I want to say to you, Sister Melissa, that God surely sees all that you do and what you and that you also help this ministry to be successful.
That's right.
To be successful. That's what the body of Christ is about. And I want to thank each and every one of you for the time that God has asked you to pray for us. I want to thank you for that, because I want to say this in honesty. There's been a few times in my life or our lives that we've ever gone through to the degree of spiritual and physical battles that we've been going through. And I'll tell you, it's been an all-out warfare, no doubt about it. But you know, God gives us the victory.
Yes.
And we're overcomers today. Amen. Yeah. No matter what we're going through, we try our very best to the grace and the mercy of God to rise above and continue to do what God asks us to do. And I got this little card here in the mail this week from my dear sister Carol that we love you this morning. She just sent this little card. You said, what good is this? Well, it's a little card that reminds us of the foliage that we've given up to be in Arizona, because we were people that love foliage, North Carolina, Connecticut, and places like that, Maine, such beautiful foliage this time of the year. But of course, here in Arizona, we don't have much of that. But thank you, Carol, for sending this to us. And you know, it's just a reminder, just look at it, just smile. Amen. You know, but I say, whatever we give up for Jesus will far exceed that in heaven morning.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes. Thank you.
And if you don't serve the Lord, you will have to give up some things.
Uh-huh.
Amen. And then the Lord, I've got a lot of things to say this morning. You just have to go with me the way the Spirit of God is flowing with me. And I'm going to be talking about today about God's Word is alive in dreams and visions. And I really want you to pay attention to this today, because so many people think it's just a so-so thing, but God assured me and speaking to me about what he's doing about the prophetic
yes.
and dreams and visions. Mm-hmm. It is not a small matter in this hour.
Mm-mm.
It never has been, but especially this hour. But a few things I just want to give you because of the heart condition of people in America today, because of the election that is coming, and how people are treating each other. And I want to read something that the Lord gave me this morning as I was getting ready. And I actually had to walk back from the bedroom to the kitchen to put this in what God told me. And you want to read this because this is a timeless piece in the Word of God. And this is found in Luke, the 18th chapter. And maybe we've read this before, we just sort of just run over right quick. But it says here is about the parable of the Pharisees and the tax collector.
Mm-hmm.
And God said, I want you to pay attention, saints in America. What is your heart like? How are you treating other people?
Oh,
how are you treating your brothers and sisters? Mm-hmm. If they don't believe exactly the way you believe, are you demonizing them? And I heard the word, you are demonizing people that's really covered by the blood of Jesus Christ. You think about that.
Wow.
And I'm hearing so much today about if you don't vote the right way, amen, the communists are going to take over. I tell you today that God is still in charge.
Amen.
God is still in charge
amen.
Today.
Amen. Yes, he is.
Well, let's read this. And you need to take this in. You need to digest this. I'm going to probably go over an hour today. Maybe, I don't know. But if you don't want to listen to what God says, that's up to you. To some, this is starting in the ninth verse, to some who was confident in their own righteousness. And there's a lot of people right now that's confident in their own righteousness. And because you feel confident in your own righteousness, you can point to everybody else and condemn them and demonize them.
Help us, Lord.
Tell me what God gave me.
Yes,
help us. I ain't pulling no punches this morning. And look down on everybody else. Did you get this? Now you need to take notes. You need to write this down. And look down on everybody else. See, if everybody don't line up where you believe, you can look down on everybody else.
It's true.
Jesus told this parable. Two men went up to the temple to pray. Two men. Now they're both going to pray. People in the house of God, maybe everybody's praying. Mm-hmm. Everybody's going to the house of God. But the Bible says it's the things that come out of your heart that defile you this morning.
Jesus.
Two men went up to the temple to pray. You know, some people can't even be in certain churches because of the way people look down on you. Because of the way they think you believe. Two men went up to the temple to pray. One a Pharisee and the other that dreaded tax collector. Dreaded. Hated. Nothing good to say about it. Isn't it amazing how God does things? And so, in the other, a tax collector, God sees in the heart. God sees in the heart this morning. The Pharisee stood up and prayed about himself. Who do you pray about? Himself. God, I thank you that I am not like other men. Wow. Isn't that self-righteous? Robbers, evildoers, adulterers, or even like this tax collector. See, God, Jesus, He spoke about those out there, but also he identified the way his heart was when he saw the one standing there next to him. Did you get that?
Yes.
The one next to him. I fast twice a week and give a tenth of all I get. It sounds like a very religious person, doesn't it? Mm. And that's what it is, religion.
Yes.
But the tax collector stood at a distance. He would not even look up to heaven, but beat his chest and said, God, have mercy on me, a sinner. Now, Jesus identifies who is who.
Yes.
That's right. He's going to identify who is who this morning.
Whoa.
Who is who this morning? Mm-hmm. You're not going to fake him out. Amen. I tell you that this man, rather than the other, went down justified before God. Not before man, but before God. For everyone who exalts himself will be humbled. And isn't that what he's doing? How many are standing in the house of God? You are exalting yourself over everybody else.
Jesus, help us.
And he who humbles himself will be exalted. So we see it. We see it. God gave that this morning to read to you that's listening to you on Sworn Eager Ministries. Amen. Let me move on now. Like I said, I've got a lot of stuff down, so we're going to keep on going forward.
That's a good word, Apostle.
Another good word that God gave me. We hate women in leadership. We hate women in leadership.
A lot of people do.
Amen. A lot of people hate women in leadership. But the Bible put in the word of God, Deborah, the prophetess. And the Bible says that Israel was having a very terrible time with the enemy. But it says that God chose a godly woman named Deborah to lead Israel in this critical time. So God sent Deborah to Israel. He sent Deborah to lead them. And the Bible says she was honored with respect of all Israel. And she led them for 40 years. Come on. She led them for 40 years. This woman was not a Democrat or Republican. She was called of God. Hello, somebody. She was called of God this morning. Why am I putting this out here? Because some of you, you will not even vote the right way. Just want to call there's a woman on the ticket, maybe. Come on, somebody.
Wow.
We would be much better if we had a woman in power this morning that was ready to lead this nation than the person that we have standing. You said, now this is about politics. No, you just listen to what I'm going to say this morning, because the Lord has been speaking to me. I've got two dreams to share with you this morning that God's given me the last 2 weeks. And the Lord said they came from him. He said, I want you to release him in the body of Christ. I want you to release him to whomsoever will this morning. And here's an amazing thing. I've had 7 dreams about this administration. 7 dreams. Every one of them have been fulfilled except these last 2. I have been watching. And God has been watching over his word to perform, to fulfill it.
Yes.
Exactly what he said.
Yes,
because he asked Jeremiah, what do you see? And I'm telling you what I'm seeing this morning. And I'm seeing because God is showing. Amen. Now we want to read this morning out of Hebrews, the 4th chapter, the 12th through the 13th verse. For the word of God is living and active. It's what? It's living and it's active. This is in NIV. It is living and active, sharper than any two-edged sword. It penetrates even and dividing the soul and spirit, joint and marrow. It judges the thoughts and attitudes of hearts. Now, didn't that Jesus? Jesus did that to the Pharisees. You get that, prophetess? He did that to the Pharisees.
Yes.
And he did that to the other man. Nothing in all creation is hidden from God's sight. Everything is uncovered, laid bare before the eyes of the one who you must give an account to. So I'm saying to you this morning, the things that I'm trying to give you and address to you, the dreams that I'm going to give you this morning, God says, they are my word and dreams and visions that's active and alive, and they are prophetic, and the things that come to pass. Things that come to pass. I don't have to tell you this morning that we're in a very rebellious nation. I don't have to tell you that. You already know that. Amen. But I do want to read to you something else the Lord said to me. He said to me a couple of weeks ago, he says, when the head is sick, the rest of the body is affected. Mm-hmm. And I found that in Isaiah 5:1, verses 5 through 7. Why should you be beaten anymore? Why do you persist in rebellion? Your whole head is sick. From the sole of your feet to the top of your head, there is not soundness, only wounds, welts, open sores, not cleansed or bandaged, soothed with oil. Your country is desolate. Your cities are burned with fire. And there's many kind of fire today. There's a natural fire and there's fires of words. Now, another scripture we've talked about several times, and we're going to say it again this morning, because God is talking about, and even in this scripture, God is predicting about the future, because 2 Chronicles, and if you never heard this before, let me tell you what God said. 2 Chronicles 7, verse chapter 7, verses 14 and 15 is prophetic.
Yes.
It is prophetic. It is prophetic that it will happen if people have an ear to hear. Now, notice how I said this one. If you have an ear to hear.
Amen.
This is talking to the church. And this is talking to leadership of the church. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves. Now, humble yourself. Know when you're doing wrong, you need to be repent of it. When you behave yourself with pride, arrogant, and pray and seek my face and turn. There's a turning here of repentance.
Yes.
From their wicked ways, murder. Mm-hmm. Did I say murder? Stealing, adultery, child abuse, loveless. Mm-hmm. Loveless, the greatest of all these, that we love one another.
Amen.
And so, from their wicked ways, then when I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and heal their land. The indictment this morning is not against politics. The indictment is against the church.
Amen.
Let me say what the word says. Mm-hmm. The indictment is against the church. Because you won't repent. You won't change. You won't be honest before God. You may have seen this. You guys know I like stock car, but I looked on one of my favorite teams and I saw the word Freedom University. And I didn't recognize this until a couple of weeks ago. Freedom University. And then it's talking about a certain university in our land today where the leadership is in chaos and they've been living in immorality.
Yes.
And the leadership has been looking away. Mm-hmm. And they've been given millions and millions of dollars just to go away. That's the kind of thing that's going on in our churches. A lot of our big churches, the leadership is corrupt. And if the leadership is corrupt, the people are probably going to be corrupt. Are you listening, Jenny?
Yes, Jesus, help us.
Yeah, help us this morning.
Yes.
What else is going on in our land this morning? What are you seeing? What are you seeing, Jeremiah? What are you seeing, Edward Chance? What are you seeing, Prophetess Linda? What are you seeing, somebody, whoever your name is this morning? Proverbs 14 and 16 says, a wise man fears the Lord and shuns evil. But a fool is hot-headed and reckless. Is our leadership, is our nation been led by a hot-headed person? Reckless leadership?
Yes.
Killing people? Infecting people?
Yes. Preaching apostles.
How long can it go on?
That's right.
How long can it go on? How long will it close blind eyes? Mm-hmm. The Lord spoke a word to me. He has spoken to my wife and we had not spoken to each other. And she got up one morning, she said, and she said, and I heard the Lord say that my people are walking blindly. They're falling blindly. I heard those same words. My people are walking blindly.
Blind leading the blind.
The blind leading the blind. Mm-hmm. And we've got that in America today. We've got the blind leading the blind. We've got the blind leading in churches. We've got the blind leading the blind. And we'd like it to be so. Hey, listen to me.
Lord Jesus, help us.
Now, I want to read something to you that you're going to have a responsibility for in the days ahead, because I said God's word is alive in dreams and visions. Now, we're going to read that out of Acts, the second chapter. Now, you need to get a hold of this. You need to have an ear to hear what the Spirit of God is saying to hear it soar in your ministries through this messenger of God this morning. And the Lord said this, and this is irrespective of male or female. This is found in Acts, the second chapter, the 17th and the 18th verse. Let me find it. The 17th and the 18th verse. Listen to this. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people. Your sons and your daughters will prophesy. Your young men will see visions. You, your old men will dream dreams. And I certainly think I qualify for that. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. The emphasis I want to make to you is that God said, I'm going to pour out my spirit. I want to tell you, The Bible says that the sons of Issachar knew the times and the seasons of the Lord.
Yes, yes.
And I'm telling you, as an Issachar vessel this morning by the power of God, that God is saying to the church and to the body of Christ, to those that are kingdom-minded, those that are walking in the kingdom of God, God is saying, I'm pouring out my spirit upon my people.
Yes.
And I pour it out upon you to prophesy, to have dreams, and to have visions from God.
Yes, yes, yes.
Did you get that? I am pouring out my spirit for dreams and visions and prophesying.
Yes.
Those three things. And God said, when that happens, He said, my word is sharper than a two-edged sword. My word is active. It is living in these dreams and visions, and it will accomplish what I please.
Yes, yes, it will. Yes, it will. That's a promise.
And you get what I'm saying here this morning. God, I sent you yesterday morning.
Bless him, Lord.
I've been up and down all week, all last week, all during the night, writing down what God is speaking in the night season. Hey, I'm just going to fulfill what God says. Now, let me give something else God gave me, just a little tidbit this morning. And we've all preached this, we've read this word of God found in Hosea. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Oh, yeah. Help us, Jesus.
Because they reject knowledge. Now, when we say knowledge, I believe that God is talking here about knowledge of spiritual and natural knowledge. Because it talks about the priests.
Right.
Amen. Mm-hmm. So spiritual and natural knowledge, my people have rejected. And I believe as we pray, come on. And it's so important, that little book of Jude found right before the book of Revelation. And God put it there so for a reason. Jude 1 and 20, but you, dear friends, build yourselves up. How many of you are building yourselves up in your most holy faith and pray in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
Keeping yourself in God's love as you wait for the mercies of the Lord at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ for eternal life.
Yes.
But what are you building yourself up for? I'm building myself up that the power of God can flow through me as a vessel of God. In dreams and visions, come on, somebody, and prophecy of the word of God.
Amen. Amen.
Are you getting this?
Yes, amen. Very good. Amen.
Hey, I got this in 5 minutes. That's the way God used to be sometimes. Half of the night in 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I'll take the 5 minutes. I'll take the 5 minutes. Now, what I'm about to say here, again, when the Lord gave me these dreams, and I understand what Jeremiah was talking about when he said, I will no longer preach your word. Because Jeremiah realized the repercussion that he was getting. Mm-hmm. But that word got so hot in his heart, he said, I can no longer forbear. But I've got to release the word of God, what God has given me. And this, we're going to look here just one more time. Now, the Lord gave me this dream, September 28th, 2020. And God gave me this dream about 2:30 in the morning. I don't know about you, I am not too crazy about getting up at 2:30 in the morning. But God kept dealing with me. He gave me this dream. I got up and I went and wrote it down. And I went back and laid down again. Here's the dream. Now, here again, it's a prophetic dream. Prophetic dreams will come to pass. Mm-hmm. It's not up to me to make it come to pass. It's not up to you to make it come to pass. But it's up to God to make it come to pass.
Yes, yes.
Now, before, when God gave me this dream, and he's talking about the president of the United States of America. And I'm not going to try to tell you anything other than what God said. God said these words to me. He is finished. Mm. I said, God, I don't want to release those words. He is finished. And I'm not talking about the polls. God said he's finished. I want you to listen to me. What I'm about to release to you. And when I told God, I didn't want to release this. Some people are all excited about it. I don't think Jeremiah was really ever excited about reading or releasing things that he knew that people would not even receive.
Right.
But here's God's word to me. Now, I know the voice of God. And I know when God means what he says.
Yes.
And he said this. And I suppose that God, if I read, said these same words to Jeremiah, and said this. In fact, he did say it to Jeremiah in the first chapter. In fact, he gave Jeremiah a head start. But he said this, I chose you. You did not choose me.
Yes. Wow.
I'm going to tell you why. I've never had God say that to me before. I've read that in the Word of God. But he said, you didn't choose me. I chose you. And that means when God is speaking, I am to release what God is saying.
Yes.
I am, as I've always said, I am not in a popularity contest.
No.
But I do want to be a friend of God. Mm-hmm. A friend of God.
Say what God says.
Say what God says.
Mm-hmm.
Now here's the dream. And I said, this is about the president of the United States of America that's in office right now. I've released 5 dreams. This is the 6th dream. I'll talk about the 7th. God committed this morning. And here's what the Lord showed me. He says, I'm in the midst of this forest. You ever been in the forest? I have as a young boy, I've been in the forest.
Yes.
And I know that when you're in a forest, most of the time, there's a lot of trees.
Yes.
Sometimes the trees are closer together, sometimes the trees are farther apart. But the dream that I'm in here, and God had me in this dream when he said he is finished. There was all these long, tall trees. Tall trees. Some of the tallest trees I've ever seen in my life. They were tall. And there was a lot of them. But there was one tree that was in the midst of them. This one tree. And when I looked, this one tree that was in the midst of all this forest, he was leaning. He was leaning over all the other trees. I take that for support. So it was leaning across all these other trees. It was not positioned to stand in his own strength. Now you're going to have to realize here that God had to give me this dream, this prophetic dream. So it was leaning across other trees. As I walked up to this tree, here again, you say, how do you know it's the president? Every dream that I had, it's always walking up to the president, either prophesying to him or speaking to him, or he's speaking to me.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You say, how do you get all these dreams? It's not by my goodness. It's not because of me. It's because of him. Mm-hmm. Are you listening to me? It's not because I pray more than you do. It's not because I read more than you do. It's not on that. It's a sovereign thing of God. A sovereign thing of God. So as I walked up to this tree, I had a chainsaw of all things in my hand. Now, I've been in the forest before with a chainsaw, and I've cut down trees in the forest to bring home and for our fireplace and things like that. But I was in this forest, and these are all green trees except this one tree. All the other trees were green, but this tree was dying.
Wow.
As I walked up to this tree, I had a chainsaw in my hand. See, I write down my dreams. I get up and go and write them down. In my hand, and I cut it down. I took this chainsaw and put it to the very, as close to the ground as I could get it, and I cut this tree down, or cut it through. My first dream started out with things being cut in the White House, if you remember. My first dream started with the pipe being cut in the White House of communication.
The foundation.
And so now this very tree that's coming into the White House, God said, I want you to cut it down. So who gave you the thought to do that? I was doing this in the dream by God's direction. You have no control over your dreams.
That's right. Amen.
I was doing what God was leading me to do. So as I cut this thing down at the bottom, this is prophetic, and then I moved up another couple of my feet as I cut it at the bottom, and it's still leaning that and like that, and I moved up and cut it another 2 or 3 feet. And that broke, and when I cut it another two or three feet, and I noticed as I was cutting the bottom, the trunk was rotten. Did you get this? The trunk was rotten.
Yes.
I mean, it was the rottenest trunk I've ever seen in my life. I've seen trunks in North Carolina when I cut those trunks or somebody just cut the tree off. And the trunks never was rotten. But this tree trunk was absolutely rotten. It just crumbled as I was cutting it. And then I cut off another section, as I said. And then the tree didn't come down, but God's an amazing God about these things. I was able to look down and look up through the tree. I officially release something to you that's leading our nation right now. This tree had a big hollow place all the way to the top. Hollow. Mm. No substance.
No
and heart. Significant.
No heart.
No heart.
Mm.
That's the very heart of the tree.
Yeah.
The very heart of the tree is the center.
Mm-hmm. Jesus.
Also, the center of the tree talks about the years of seasoning and growth that a tree has. Did you hear me? Wow. So as I cut this thing off, and it's still there, as I looked up and I saw it, this hollow going through it, I looked at the word hollow. And you know, the Bible says a tree is known by its fruit, doesn't it?
Yes.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
He says if a tree is corrupt, it will not give good fruit.
Yes.
If a tree is good, it will give good fruit. God is showing that this tree has never been good.
Yes. Oh, Jesus. Never.
Mm. And this is the liar that you put into my mouth this morning. He's never been good. Six. Bankruptcies. Filing bankruptcies. How can a casino go bankrupt?
Mm-hmm.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
Remember rotten. Let me get you the word rotten. It was very rotten. It just fell apart. It was very broke. No substance to it. Let me say something else to you. You say, well, how about Nebuchadnezzar when God cut it down? When he told Daniel to go and tell Nebuchadnezzar that if he didn't do right, he was going to cut it down. And he did. But God did something about Nebuchadnezzar. He didn't show me in this. Nebuchadnezzar, when he cut him down and put him in out there with the cows and stuff.
Wow.
The Bible said he put an iron ring around that trunk of the tree. And he put a bronze covering on it to preserve it. That one day he would come back. This tree is corrupt to never come back. Rotten means decaying, putrid. Tainted, foul, corrupt, morally offensive, wretched, bad smelling, unpleasant. Does that sound familiar? Does that sound familiar? Don't try to label me of who I support. I am exposing who God gave me to expose.
That's right.
So many are following this man blindly. My wife's nephew this morning was cussing people on the Facebook and talking about, you know, communism is going to take over the nation. I thought, my Lord, we see trying to capture the governor of Michigan. And this is the kind of thing which we are allowing to happen in our land because of the man standing in the White House. Because of his attitude and his spirit of white supremacy. Now, I know some of y'all might have cut me off right about now, but I'll stand as a witness one day.
Yes.
I'll stand. God told me, you, my son, will stand as a witness. Jeremiah stood as a witness. Oh, somebody go ahead and say amen.
Amen.
And also, I heard also these words. I heard these words, I wrote them down this week. Hollywood, ego, and failure about this president. Hollywood, ego, and failure. Why should I be praising and worshiping a man in the White House when it's his responsibility to lead this nation.
Yes.
We voted him in to do this. Whether it be male or female. You know, Saul was destroyed by his own words, committed, fell on his own sword, didn't he? Isn't that right?
No.
And so as God's message to you this morning, God is releasing to me that I'm releasing to you this morning. And I'm glad this thing's going to be over pretty soon because I don't enjoy it.
Yes, amen.
But rotten again means corrupt completely. Mm-hmm. Corrupt completely. Hollow means no substance. Hollow means empty inside. Hollow means without significance. Hollow means void. Can't produce anything that is good.
Mm.
Amen. As I said, I was very hesitant to want to put this out there, but I've tried my very best in the time that God's been talking about the last 4 years of putting out the time that God says. And I, like I said, I never thought that God would ever use me to be speaking this way to a nation, Facebook, Periscope, or whoever it may be this morning. But and then God did something else. Now, God is an awesome God.
Yes, he is.
I was sitting here writing. God gave me this at about 2:30. I got up at 4:30 in the morning to write this down because God would not let me rest. Now, you can only lay in the bed and pray so long before you know you've got to get up and do something. So I lay there and I prayed, and God would not let me rest. So I said, now this is 2 hours later. 2:30, 3:30, yeah, 4:30, okay. 4:30, I'm sitting here at the table. Everybody in the house is asleep. My wife's asleep. My daughter's asleep. My son's asleep. And probably everybody else is asleep. Except there is somebody in our church who was not asleep. If I'm writing this dream out on October the 2nd, now the dream came in October the 28th, but I'm writing it out on October the 2nd. I'm sitting there writing this dream out, 4:30 in the morning, and this sister has never done this in times past.
Our spiritual daughter.
Our spiritual daughter. And yes, you may say she's not perfect. Well, I'm not perfect either, but I do cover by the blood of Jesus Christ. And I know she's going to get some things together in her life. Amen. But you know what? Listen to me. And many all of you are growing right now to get things together in your life. Go ahead and say amen. You are growing to get things together in your life right now.
Amen.
Amen. Moving on. Moving forward. Moving up. Growing. Putting on more spiritual muscles this morning. And so this sister, bless her heart, was in tune with God.
Thank you, Lord.
In tune with God. And here's the man sitting here saying, God, I don't want this responsibility of giving this thing out this morning. Now listen to this. So I heard my messages go off, and I wondered who in the world could be sending anything to my messenger this morning. So I opened my phone, and here's the message. And she is encouraging us. She's encouraging me. She's speaking God's blessing over us, over our household. She's thanking God for being her spiritual leaders and things like this. And I did take a moment to just text her back and say thank you for that word of encouragement.
Yes, yes.
Because she don't know the battle that I was going through talking to God about this dream.
Yes.
Did you hear me, sister, this morning? Is she on there this morning?
I didn't see her.
She may or may not be. She may come on later on. But let me say this morning to you, heaven is in charge.
Yes, he is.
Man may oppose God's word, he may oppose God's authority, but God will have the last say.
Yes.
Amen. Let me read you something out of Jeremiah. You say, are you hung up on Jeremiah? No. That's where God just leads me. Jeremiah 51, verse 69. Flee out of the midst of Babylon and deliver every man his soul. Be not cut off in her iniquity. For this is the times of the Lord's vengeance, He will render unto her her recompense. In other words, God has said he's going to render to Israel for all the sin that she has done. Is God talking to America this morning? Now I'm going to get to something else in closing today. It took me a few minutes. Let me move on to the next dream that God gave me. And this is not only about our president, but this is about the preachers. I remember standing in a certain huge denominational church. And you've heard me say this before, and I heard God say in the midst of all these thousands of people. And I heard these words that I heard this week, you cannot be a part of this. They wanted to ordain me and all these things. I said, okay, I'm sorry, I can't be a part of this. Of course, I found out a lot of things about this church today that does not represent Jesus Christ. Amen. My position, and your position should be kingdom people.
Yes.
Hello, kingdom people. About the kingdom. Mm-hmm. About the kingdom. Not my will, but thine be done. And I'm going to know what the will of God is. And you should know what the will of God is. In this hour, in this time, you should know what the will of God is. Even who to vote for.
Yes, that's right.
Now, there's a lot of ministers, there is a lot of preachers, there's a lot of denomination of preachers that are telling you who to vote for.
That's right.
Vote
who you want to.
And they're using the fear tactic against you in this election. Oh, yeah. Some very denominational big ministries are using fear tactics to say the communists is going to come in if you don't vote a certain way.
Charismatic churches, too, are doing that.
You know, some of these very places where this particular person was saying this, we have drove into this state and it is demonically oppressed. Here's what the Lord said. God said, are you kingdom saints that don't operate in fear?
Wow.
Those are the words God gave me this morning. Mm-hmm. As I said, I always come and sit at the table to put the finishing touches on. In case I missed something. In case God wants to speak further.
Yes.
And so God said, kingdom saints don't operate in fear. Mm-hmm. And if someone is trying to cause you to operate in fear this morning, you need to resist that and say, God, who do you want me to vote for? And the Bible says that God, that his sheep should know his voice. Now, if you're an American saint, your vote may be different. And you avoid who God wants. I said, you will avoid who God wants. But God said, I'm bringing things down where you cannot flee certain beliefs any longer. That's wrong and hypocritical.
Wow.
What I heard, wrong and hypocritical. You demonize everybody else and justify what you want. That's where I started with. Trump and the church. White supremacy. They lied. Did you know that the church had a lot to do with destroying the American Indian in their day? Did you know that? But the Lord said, I'm exposing lies, thoughts, and intents of the heart because of my word.
Yes.
That you're going to have to repent. You're going to have to repent. And repent means you have to turn around.
Wow.
Now, this seventh dream that I'm about to give you was given to me on October the 4th, 6 or 7 days after I had the last dream. This is the seventh dream that God gave me. And God's been giving me dreams since 2000 what, 16, I guess it is, to 2020. Ministers, and this is not a Hollywood movie. This is a reality movie. This is a movie according to the word of God prophetically that God said is taking place as I speak. As I speak. Think about it. As I speak, this is going on.
Wow.
Now, I've been in Africa, and I've been privileged to be with my spiritual son on the plantation. And I've been privileged to see laborers working in the plantation where they're cutting off bananas and things like that with the machete. That thing is razor sharp. I've seen them walking down the dirt path with these machetes in their hands. And brother, they get the job done. Machetes. I mean, that is a violent looking knife to start with.
Right.
That is not a Jim Bowie knife. That is a machete. That is a machete that you hold in your hand and the blade is something like this.
Wow.
And it cuts whatever you aim at. Mm-hmm. It is very sharp. And the Lord showed me a machete. Does not the word say in the land, in the days of Noah, there shall be violence in the land? Let me bring violence to the degree that God is bringing violence in America today. And we can trace this back to the days of Noah. You say, what is the significance of this dream? Oh, it is paramount. It is paramount. We know the scriptures well in the third and the fourth chapter of Revelation. He that had an ear to hear what the Spirit of God is saying to the church. It's about the Spirit we hear with our spiritual ear.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, what did I see? I'm glad you asked. As it was in the days of Noah, so shall it be in the days of the coming of the Son of Man. Ministers cutting off ears by the Spirit of Almighty God as a sword. Mm. Did you get that? As a sword. Spiritually cutting off people's ears. Spiritually with the sword and using the Word of God. Did you get that? In this October the 4th, cutting off the ears. Both sides, on both sides of people's head, the ears been cut off by this machete. They were cut off one side, they would turn the head around and cut off the other side. And I saw ears been cut off in the mud. And saw the ears falling down. Now that's a gross scene. That is not Hollywood written. Ears on both sides, that they could no longer hear the enemy. Enemy. Now, I'll give you another word.
Jesus.
I'll give you another word that came from the Spirit of God. Ministers hot that are hired to cut your ears off. Hirelings. Hirelings. Hired to cut off your ears by the enemy that people could no longer hear what God is saying.
Jesus.
Did you hear what I said?
Mm. Help us, Lord.
The enemy in this election don't want you to hear what God's Spirit is saying.
Right.
Not to hear, but to fear, to be intimidated by that preacher standing in the pulpit. Come on. God said, don't hear them. You hear God. Don't be intimidated by them. They're just men. They're mere men. He said, they'll turn me out of the church. Well, they turned Jesus out of the church. The blind leading the blind. Demonizing people. Pressuring people.
Manipulate.
But they don't tell you the evil schemes that's going on behind the scenes.
Wow.
So they're trying to remove your ability to hear. And the Lord showed me something else. Because the Bible says in the last days they're going to try to change the laws of God. removing the ability to hear, removing the ability to hear the law of God's Spirit. Did you get that? Removing the ability of God's people to hear the law of God's Spirit. Not to any longer hear what the Spirit of God is saying.
Yes.
To the church.
Jesus.
That's quite an indictment, because you've got a responsibility. So I saw people's ears been violently cut off. Blood oozing as that machete knife was coming down. Men hired to destroy. And in this dream, they were chasing me. And I take demon spirits are trying to chase us.
Yes.
But you are defeated in the name of Jesus Christ.
Yes, 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 yes.
Demon spirits are defeated in the name of Jesus Christ. Ironically, in this dream, as they were chasing me, and I came to this shack, and something else unusual appeared at this shack. Here was a police woman come to my defense.
Thank you, Jesus.
Wow. Isn't God something?
Police woman.
A police, not a police man, but a police woman.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So they want you to be deaf mute. They want you to no longer hear God's word, voice. It's going to be up to you. And Jeremiah's day, they did the same thing. They didn't want people to hear.
Yes.
But Jeremiah warned God's people of impending danger. Mm-hmm. The nation. I'm going to ask you right now in closing, what is God doing and developing in your life today that's kingdom?
Thank you, Jesus.
For the future.
Yes.
That's kingdom for the future. Jeremiah said in Jeremiah 33:3, call to me and I will answer you and tell you great and unsearchable things that you do not know. And I believe this is the result of that Spirit of God that has been poured out upon you this morning.
Yes.
Poured out in dreams and poured out in vision and poured out in prophecy.
That's right.
And poured out through his word.
Amen.
And again, Jeremiah 22:21 warned them again. I warned you when you felt secure. This is God talking to the church. You feel secure in what you're doing right now, but you're going to regret it if you don't turn around. I warned you when you feel secure. Man, there's a lot of preachers this morning that feel secure and arrogant, standing in the pulpit saying it's God, when it is not God at all.
Yes.
They are liars. They're found to be false. I warn you when you felt secure. America, you are prosperous and you're feeling secure, but there's a lot of people that need God's help this morning. But you said, I will not listen. What? Preachers are saying this morning, I will not listen to what God says. I will listen to the president. I will recklessly move on in the congregation, and I will deceive and lie to the people. But there's another part of this. Jeremiah said, and the people love it to be so.
Yes.
I will not listen. This has been your way from your youth. You have not obeyed me. Now, you need to check out your heart. Maybe you've been rebelling all the time. And it is time to recognize what's going on.
Jesus.
Now, in closing, as I've been speaking to religious people, religious nation, politics, I'm sure, turmoil, unrest, confusion, division. And this is all to speaking of religious people.
Yes.
But being kingdom people, we want to hear what the king is saying. Amen.
Yes, amen.
You may disagree with me, but I still am going to love you.
That's right.
You may disagree with me and despise me, but whose heart will be right?
Mm-hmm.
Whose heart will be right? I'm going to close right. I'm going to read one more thing and close it. And that's going to be the end of the story for this session. But I'm telling you, saints, I am delivering what the Spirit of the Lord says to me. And I've got five more minutes found in Jeremiah 1 through the 14th verse. And I want you to, if you will, go with me and just read that together. I know it's going off. I'll give it a minute. Amen. God said it's 12 o'clock. Hallelujah. Let the word of God, let clock strike. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody been ugly? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You can be ugly, but you're going to face a God. Hallelujah. Let's read in closing today. Jeremiah 7:7 verses 1 through 14. Now, God is talking to the religious, false, religious, worthless people. Did you get that? False, religious, worthless people. Not hearing what God has to say.
Jesus, help us, Lord.
This is the word that came to Jeremiah from the Lord. So we want to understand who it's coming from. This is not Jeremiah having a Jeremiah ministry. This is a God ministry. Stand at the gate of the Lord's house, and there proclaim this message. This is delivered to God's people. Hear the word of the Lord, all you people of Judah who come through these gates to worship the Lord. This is what the Lord Almighty, the God of Israel, says. Reform your ways. America, reform your ways. Churches, reform your ways. And your actions. See, you can't have ways unless you've got actions.
Jesus.
What you think, you will have to say it. And I will let you live in this place. Do not listen now. Listen. And here's the deception and the lie that's going on in our land. And this is the deception, and this is cutting off ears, and this is blinding the eyes, and this is speaking twisting the word of God, and this is demonizing people. Do not trust in deceptive words and say, this is the temple of the Lord. The temple of the Lord. The temple of the Lord. That sounds so religious, doesn't it?
Yes.
That sounds so sincere. Sincere. If you really change your ways and your actions and deal with each other justly, if you do not oppress the alien, the foreigner, what are we doing in America? We are oppressing the foreigners, those that's here illegally, those that's trying to come here, those, come on, we are oppressing them, the fatherless, or the widow, and do not shed innocent blood in this place. And if you do not follow other gods to your own harm, then I will let you live in this place. There are if clauses in here. In the land I give your forefathers forever and ever. But look. God has been realistic here. But look, you are trusting in this. Here it is. God's already written their heart by the word of God. He's already divided their very words, their thoughts, their intent, their mara, their bone. He divided everything. He's exposed everything about them. But look, you are trusting in deceptive words that are worthless. Will you steal and murder and commit adultery and perjury, burn incense to Baals and follow other gods you have not known, and then come and stand before me in this house?
Yes.
God said, I'm tired of your hypocritical life, which bear my name and say, we are safe. Safe to do all these detestable things. Has this house which bear my name become a den of thieves or robbers? Did not Jesus prefer to chastise this in the New Testament? Or face this in the New Testament? dear robbers to you, but I have been watching, declares the Lord. Now, if you want to wonder who's been watching over this nation and who's been watching what's going on and watching their lives, and it's God. But now God is using his servants, his messengers, to convey and release to you what he's seeing. What are you seeing, Jeremiah? This is what God is showing. Go down to the house of Shiloh, where I first made a dwelling for my name, and see what I did to it because of the wickedness of my people of Israel.
Yes.
Oh, God's going to judge wickedness. Mm-hmm. He's going to judge hypocritical people. He's going to judge hypocrites. He's going to judge liars and fornicators and greed. While you were doing all of these things, declared the Lord, I spoke to you again and again. This is not the first time you've been warned. But you did not listen. I called you, but you did not answer. Therefore, what I did to Shiloh, I will now do to the house that bears my name, the temple you trust in, the place I gave you and your fathers. I will thrust you from my presence as I did all your brothers, the people of Ephraim. Now listen. God says, have you reached the point where God says, I'm no longer going to deal with you? Have you reached the point where God said, my presence is no longer going to be with you?
Jesus.
I don't know about you, but I cannot imagine anything more frightening than to think about the presence of God being moved from our lives. So we must return to the Lord. We must return to Jesus Christ and walk the way we should. When we want to become a part of those who could be said, this is they which turned the world upside down.
Yes, there you go.
I believe this message is about turning the world upside down. I believe this message is about you need to get sober. You need to start thinking the right way. Mm-hmm. You need to listen to God. You need to be truthful. Amen. I'm going to stop. There's two of the things I have in it that's not as important as what I just gave you. But what I've released to you, the Lord has released to me. Amen. I don't apologize for it. I don't ask for forgiveness for it. I am not arrogant about it. I just say I've released what God gave me as the messenger of God this morning. And I thank him for supporting me and for standing with me, with his angels, with the kingdom of God this morning. I thank him for it. I thank you for standing with us this morning. Some of you I may not even know. I may not never meet you on this side of earth. Amen. But I want to thank you for your prayers.
Yes.
I covet your prayers this morning. Because you don't give messages like this and think that there's no repercussions.
That's right.
You don't give messages like these and think that all hell is angry. And the Bible says we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but we wrestle against principalities and powers of the air. We realize that, but also we realize where the demonic spirits are coming from.
Yes, yes.
We're not that crazy.
Mm-mm.
Thank you, Lord. We're not that crazy. So I'm saying to you, let your vote count this election. And don't let anybody fool you, trick you, and cause you not to listen to the voice of your conscience. You know, the Lord said to me, since he knows all things. And I don't know about you, but I believe that God knows all things. And he said about Jeremiah, I knew you before you was even born. That means that Jeremiah, God knew everything about Jeremiah. He knew everything he was going to do. He knew every weak place in his life, but God still chose Jeremiah. Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. He chose him to be his spokesman.
Yes.
God knows everything about you this morning. He knows everything about every human being that's on the face of the earth this morning. And so this morning, walk with him. Thank him this morning. Thank you for his goodness in your life.
Yes,
say, Lord, let me be honorable in serving you today. Let me be honorable in serving you today. Father, as I pray for each and every one that is here today, I pray for those today, Almighty God, that's walking with you. Those that they may be struggling or staggering. Those that's been questioning. Those this morning, God, that's been trying to make up their minds. Those this morning trying to stand up and be counted in the kingdom of God this morning. Those this morning is not like a domino effect. Those will be counted in the kingdom of God this morning. Those that will hear the voice of God. Those that will change this morning because God has purposes and plans for your life. And you cannot run with the chickens. You got to go with the eagles. You got to go with the eagles. Sometimes you're going to lose friends. Sometimes you're going to lose friends because you want to choose the right way. I choose the right way.
That's right.
Thank you, Lord. Because you truly know, you've heard, I can't go that way.
Yeah.
I can't go that way. And so, Father, I pray for those today who are sick in their bodies, who are making difficult choices today. I pray for those today, Lord, that's in financial need,
yes,
that you will meet their needs today.
God, help them.
Yes, Lord, that you would help them when there seems like there is no help. Yeah. They turn to you and there is help. There is help. You have a way that man knoweth not of. You have funds laid aside that's available for those that called upon you this morning and welcome with you. And that are given into the kingdom of God today. You're going to have to honor your word to them. That's right. You're going to have to honor your word to them.
Yes.
He said, I will honor my word to you because you've been faithful to me, saith the Lord. You've been faithful. Someone was telling me this week, they were talking to the Lord, God, I have been faithful in my tithes and offerings. I have been faithful in all that you asked me to do. And Lord, I am believing you.
Yes.
And just how God came through for them. That's the God that we serve today.
Amen.
No matter how bleak it may be looking at your life right now, I want to say to you, amen, you can fall back on God. He's full of grace. He's full of mercy today. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Saints, thank you today for being with us. We will be back with you Sunday morning. I don't know if they're going to be trying to do anything. Thursday's going to be up to them. We'll see how it goes but we will say that Pastor Edward's going to be back Sunday morning, this Sunday morning. I'm looking forward to the next word of God. We're going to move forward. We're going to move on. But don't let your vote be counted for nothing today. Don't let the enemy lie to you and fool and trick you out of voting. Amen. Amen. What you believe is right in the Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I shared these dreams with you. I've shared what God has shared with me. And God said, my word is alive and is active. What? And it's going to come to pass and is coming to pass right now. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't let anybody take your ears off. Don't let anybody, amen, cut your ears off. Don't let anybody blind you. Don't let anybody deceive you this morning. In Jesus' name we pray. God bless you, and we'll see you next Sunday. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.